CleanStyles is a Webflow app I created to help clean your CSS file inside your Webflow project. It can help you find duplicates, it merges combo classes, and it renames classes in bulk. I've created this app last year, and this year we introduced the 2.0 version, a total revamp, a new app that I really hope you guys like, and I'm eager to hear your feedback, if any. Just shoot me a message or drop it in the comments below. Okay, so let's check out CleanStyles. Now, CleanStyles is available in the marketplace, so you guys can check it out. And once you install it on your website, you'll have it here and we can launch it here. And as you can see, it has these three options for now, these three features. Soon we'll be doing the style analytics, which is something that we'll be using AI. However, that's something that will be coming up in the future. For now, we have these three features. And as you can see, you have this dashboard, so you can go through the features from here. And you can see it's a version 2.0 now here. So this is the version that we're going to play with. So first, let's test out these features. So I like the find duplicates. Now, find duplicates was the original feature that came with this app. So I made this app for finding duplicates. However, this year with all the advancements, I thought we need some more features in CleanStyles. So let's go through duplicate style detection. So you have this quick scan and a deep scan. So deep scan basically goes through all the pages, scans everything, scans all the duplicate classes, and it scans the combo classes applied on elements, on components, and furthermore. For this video, we're just going to check out the quick scan. So if I go on quick scan, as you can see, now I have here some groups. So these are groups of duplicates that I have on my website. And as you can see, for example, let's check out this one's four styles. So I have four styles that share the same property, which is font size 1 rem. Now, this happens a lot on projects. It happens if multiple people work on a project. It happens if the style guide or the setup of the project is not very well prepared. And it's common and it's okay. So that's why I created this app. Now, in this case, I have these four classes that share this 1 rem, and I want to duplicate them, or I would like to merge them all in this class. So each one of them says text size 16 and remove all these rest. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all these four, and then you scroll down and you can see we have selected the four. And then here I have the option to create a new class or merge these into an existing class. And this is what we want to do. I've also laid out this option to skip component elements if you'd like. Of course, that would be faster for your scan. However, component elements are pretty much heavily used now, so I kept that option as a default, and it's up to you to change it. And then we go in the list here and we choose text size 16, and that's the class that I want to unify everything into, and then I can start merging. And here as well, you can see I have this breakpoint analysis where you can see if it's a perfect match in breakpoints or if there's any difference in the tablets, mobile landscape, or mobile portrait between these classes. However, in this case, I have them as a perfect match. And you can see here it says perfect match. That means all the breakpoints match, everything match, and it's a proper duplicate. However, in some cases it's not, like here, and we'll check it out in a bit. So for now, let's go for this and start merging. Now, to merge, it takes a bit of time. Now, due to the Webflow API, it has to go through all the pages one by one. And that's a limitation from the API itself. However, this is the only way we can go through it and make sure that we change all the elements on the site that use any of these classes in the list. And that's what it's doing. As you can see it in the background doing that. And it's just going to go through all the pages, all the components, all the elements, and change whatever it needs to change. And then it gives me a preview. So let's wait for it. And of course, you can always hide this log. So we can hide the log and like continue working or continue browsing classes. Okay, I think it's done. So here it says merged three classes. Oh, I missed the notification. However, it now merged everything into text size 16. So now if we go look in the styles panel, if you go to styles panel and you look for text size, let's say regular, which was there before, it's not there anymore. And if we look at text size 16, it's right here. And now it's being used on multiple places, as you can see, and in a component. So everything that was the duplicate group that we saw now says text size 16, which is great. Now, furthermore, you can see if some classes have a combo class. So in this case, I have this app apps here, and it's telling me that this is used in a combination. Padding Small does not. So I want to discover what this combination is. So I do a deep scan, or you can just do a deep scan for all, and then it does a deep scan, or like the deep scan we saw in the beginning. And that's where basically it just detects all the combination, any styles or any elements that are being combined with other elements, combo classes, secondary classes, whatever you call them. We're going to find them out here. So in this case, apps is the one with a combination, and we want to know what it's combined with. So it's combined with cart content bordered. So I know what's going on here. Either I merge it and I know that this might change or something's going to be affected there, or I can just go to it and create a class. So I like creating a separate class for combo classes so that they always have their own class apart from me using them in a combo. This way you can improve your CSS file, use less lines, and just use combo classes. I mean, combo and utility classes are the best. They're really good, but they're just a bit hard to maintain. And that's why we need apps like this to help us maintain all these complications. Now, enough with find duplicates. Next, we're going to go into bulk rename. So bulk rename does what it says. It just bulk renames folders. So there are folder patterns. So if you name your classes like this, so let's say folder underscore than the name. So whatever is here, you can reuse it. So I know some client first or Loomis uses the system where they put the underscore for the main folder, let's say, and then the element will go after. So in this case, we have these folders and all these are detected here. So for example, utility page, this is a utility page. As you can see, utility page underscore form, utility page underscore image, utility page underscore component. Now, I want to change this name. Maybe I want to call it UP instead of utility page just to make it smaller. And then what I do here, if I rename all, it's going to change this UP across all these elements, and it's not going to be utility page anymore. And let's do that. Let's rename them all. So it's renaming them all. It's detecting where they are, and then it goes on and change them. Now, this was quicker than expected, which is great because it already scroll through the website, so it knows where everything is. So as you can see here, we have up form, up image, up component, up form block, and the utility pages. Utility is not there anymore, and that's great. Now, another way of doing this, I know some templates use space instead of underscore. Now, I'm trying to do this because I see a lot of use of space, so I just did this. For example, in here it's form, it says form block. It could have form input, form whatever, and this way you can also bulk rename those in bulk. That's it for bulk rename. Okay, so finally, let's check out combo merge. Now, combo merge is still in beta, so it's still a work in progress. However, the idea of combo merge is that it merges combo classes into one new class. So you can see that if you have the element selected, it detects it. It tells you, okay, this is the element selected. In this case, it's a single class, so we can't merge anything. But if I click on this one, I can see that this one is a combo class. It's these two classes that I want to merge into this new class that I have. So I'm going to call this, let's say, form input new. So this is form input new. And I'm going to merge this into two classes. Now, as you can see, we had options to delete unused classes. So let me just go back through that. We missed it. But you have options to delete unused classes and to be able to only change the instance that you have selected. But in this case, I just want to merge through all the website, scan it, make sure that I have all the classes that has this combo class changed to the new class. And this is what it's doing right now. So let's wait and see. All right, so now it's done. It tells me that it changed 9 elements. So we have 9 elements that has this new combo class called form input new, and this is changed into this. You can see it also changed the other classes that were there that used the same combo, and that's basically how combo merge works. And that's clean styles for you, so I really hope you guys like it. Now, any feedback, any bugs that you see, any ideas that you have, please do share them with me. I'm very open to making this app more useful for the entire community. I use it myself sometimes to merge combo classes, for example. This is one of the tools that I use often. However, I want to make sure that this app is really good for cleaning styles across different workflow scenarios. If you're liking these videos, do subscribe to the channel, do give it a thumbs up, and wait for the next one, which is going to be coming soon. See you then.